was born in South Wales and raised in a village called Penclawdd on the Gower Peninsula. My father was a school teacher by profession, but also a church chapel, in fact, choir master and organist. And he was hugely influential in my early life. He exposed me to music, he taught me the piano, music theory. From an early age, I wanted to be a musician. I mean, he taught me the piano. I wasn't a particularly good pianist, in the sense I wasn't a prodigy or even that brilliant. And it wasn't late until I started playing the oboe when I went to the local grammar school that I found an instrument that suited me and which I was relatively good on. Well, when I went to university, which was at Cardiff, University of Wales, by this time I was playing the oboe in the National Youth Orchestra of Wales, so that kind of side of things was carrying on as per normal and developing. But I developed a great interest in jazz during my teenage years. And what attracted me to jazz was the kind of vibrancy, the energy, the improvisational element, but also the fact that the music was tonal. Whereas in my academic life, as far as composition went, it was one could only write kind of atonal dissonant music, which didn't appeal to me as a writing medium, whereas jazz did for the reasons I've just explained. So I've always kind of drifted on my life. I've never had a clear career path or plan, but I wanted to play jazz. So I went to the academy and I'd met a few musicians previously, a guy called Graham Collier, who ran a band, and he said, "When you come to London, give me a ring." So I started playing jazz outside the academy as well. And unusually, as one of the few jazz oboists in captivity, there was, I think I was almost the only one this side of the Atlantic, and there were a couple in America who were doing the same kind of thing. And by this time, I'd added saxophone to what I was doing, and keyboard, so I was a kind of multi-instrumentalist. So that's what I did. When I played in Soft Machine, it was a fantastic period, partly because of the time of when it was politically. Being on the road as a young man was fun. But it wasn't a true home for me ever, because I always thought of myself as, well, I was a competent jazz player. I wasn't as good as many others. I subsequently kind of wandered, really, and which I've done through my life, musically, and hit on certain things at certain times that had been fortuitous. And it was much later when I found my natural home. I formed a company with an old colleague of mine within Soft Machine called Mike Ratledge, who was a founder member and a keyboard player. And we both tired of touring at roughly at the same time. This would be about 1980-ish, I think. And we decided to form a company together. We both were based in London. I think I just met my wife, but a few years before. I didn't want to go on the road, didn't want to settle, but had to earn a living. And the only thing I could do was within music. So we decided to form a company that was kind of multi-purpose initially. We were kind of ready to go in any direction, music production, film scoring, arrangements, orchestrations for people, and music for TV commercials was one of these many routes that we could have chosen. So we went in a few different areas, and then the kind of commercial side of it took off amazingly well. Adiemus was a kind of phenomenon that came out of indirectly out of advertising, and that I had this idea for a while to compose some music that was essentially based on Western European principles, like choral music, but where the sound world of the choir was more akin to ethnic music or third world music and not a kind of European classical trained voice or voices, a more kind of unique and ethereal and in one way, and another direction a more kind of tribal, earthy kind of African singing. Once this was in kind of gestation, really, I was asked to write some music for, or we were asked to write some music for a Delta Airline commercial. And they wanted something ethnic, you know. And Adiemus was born, and it was used on the commercial and became very successful. Along the way, I'd picked up a mission of mine, in a way, is in that to write music based in Western classical European principles, but hugely influenced by outside that by ethnic and third world cultures, both in the use of instruments and in the use of text. So as you say, I became a kind of a choral composer, and also went back to writing concertos and things like that.